Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya and the Commander-in-Chief of the Kenya Defence Forces, Your Lordship, the Bishop, Chairperson of the Kenya Conference of Catholic Bishops, the Catholic Church leaders present here, the Vice Chancellor of Catholic University of East Africa, my colleagues from the Minister of Education, led by my brother and my friend, our Principal Secretary, Dr. Belio Kipsang, and my sister, Madam Nancy Masharia, the CEO of the Teacher Service Commission, who's here. I think, Nancy, the principals need to know that you are here so that they can be comfortable. Please raise up and wait. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Your Excellency, it gives us great pleasure to be here. I know for sure that after the general elections on the 8th of August, this is probably one of your first functions, and to choose to be with us as teachers and the education sector, we are truly grateful to Your Excellency. And this, as said earlier by Bishop Muhati, emphasizes and underlines the fact that you truly value the work that we do as teachers, as educators, as people who spend time with the children of this country. Your Excellency, I would like to take this opportunity to very sincerely, again, on my own behalf and on behalf of my colleagues in the education sector in the country, to express gratitude to the Catholic Church and the entirety of its leadership. We've had a fantastic collaborative relationship with the Catholic Church. And actually, the Catholic Church, as everyone knows, because this is a fact, is the largest faith-based investor in the education sector. And in terms of education in our country, when you look at the history of the investments that have gone to education, the church was in education before the state, and therefore the church has remained a very valuable partner in all our programs and our activities. It is true, Your Excellency, that we work very closely, and I want to say here that we have benefited a lot from constant collaboration, constant engagement with the leadership of the church on all matters education. Your Excellency, before I invite you to speak, I need to report to you that the guidance you have given us and all your directives on what we need to do to reform the education sector in the country are on course. Your Excellency, you gave us a plan. And on behalf of my colleagues, I want to thank you for trusting us enough to implement your plan in the education sector. And as has been said by both the Bishop and the leaders that we have interacted before, your plan to reform the education sector of our country is on course. We worked very well to reform the test and measurement system, to reform the examination system. We worked very well together with the church to reform the curriculum. Your Excellency, we are working together now with the church to reform the way in which we address the spiritual needs of our children in schools. Because, as you told us, Your Excellency, when you gave us directives to do this, you want our children to grow up to be educated, yes, but to be also responsible all-round individuals in our society. Your Excellency, I want to report to you that the collaboration with the church, especially on the issue of introducing the new program of chaplaincy for schools, has worked very well. And I can assure you, sir, that we are on course to implement your program as you have instructed us to do. Finally, Your Excellency, we can't do much without a collaboration. As you have pointed out to us before, Your Excellency, you instructed us in 2014 that you want us to adopt a partnership approach in the management of the education sector and the country at large. Your Excellency, it is your vision, as you told us, that we should work as one and that we should deliver as one. And therefore, as a result, we have built sustainable partnerships in the education sector. and the church has remained a very valuable partner in that particular regard. I want to assure you, sir, that we will continue to work in that same manner to implement your vision of delivering as one and working together as partners as we drive the country forward. Usually, Your Excellency, I come to these meetings, and I can assure you I have a good time with these good people here. Sometimes they're more relaxed than they are now, because today they are before the President. But we've had a wonderful collaboration, and I want to assure you, Your Excellency, that we will continue to implement the programs that you have asked us to implement in the education sector according to the schedule that you gave us. We are on schedule on all the plans that you gave us, whether it's on curriculum reform. We have just completed the pilot project, Your Excellency, piloting the curriculum. The schedule that you insisted we adhere to, we will adhere to it. And Your Excellency, I want to report further to you that the instructions you gave us last year when we were releasing the results, that you want, by the time we are going into the exams this year, to have completed the process of giving our candidates unique personal identifiers. I want to assure you, sir, that that plan is on course, and I want to assure you that by the grace of God, your dream of transforming the way we manage data in the education sector is going to be realized because of the work that has been done by all these good people here. Lastly, sir, I can't forget to thank the principals as the people who are at the frontier of what we do. When we are at home as parents or we are at headquarters as policymakers, we depend on these men and women to look after our children for 9 months out of 12 months in a year. They do a fantastic job. We thank them so much, and we are even more grateful that our colleagues at TSC have now completed the CBA. It has been signed, and Nancy and her team have been effective in looking after the welfare of our principals and our teachers across the country. I therefore want to assure you, Your Excellency, that as you have instructed us before, that you don't want to see industrial instability in the education sector. We will do our best, those of us you have given the responsibility to look after this sector. Not just to live up to the plans that you have given us, and not just to implement the things you have told us to implement, but to also translate your vision of building a country that engages in conversations, a country that focuses on the importance, including its own children. And Your Excellency, we thank the Lord for you, and we thank the Lord for the great country that we have, and we continue to prayerfully hope that we will keep the peace, we will stay the course, we will remain focused, and the education sector of our country is going places as we move forward.